Shabazz pounces. Black up.
Hey! I hope everyone is doing well, doing good. Anthony Fantano here, the internet's busiest music nerd. It's time for an album review. Shabazz Palaces, Black Up. As far as I can tell, Shabazz Palaces is a hip-hop project led by Palacier Lazaro. But that's not his real name. He's actually Ishmael Butler, who used to be in the 90s hip-hop outfit Digital Planets. But you don't need to hear that stuff to enjoy this. Palacier also brings on some collaborators for this LP, but as far as I can tell, they are anonymous or working under pseudonyms that I saw listed out on a Sub Pop Records website. If anything, you should try to check out the two self-releases that Shabazz put out before this new LP, Black Up.
And
how to attack this, because there's so many things to say about it. Let's start with the beats and the production, because it's such a vital part to this album. I would say more so than a lot of hip-hop albums, and I say that because there are so many points where the textures and the effects and the samples and the beats basically take over and maybe drown out the lyricism a little bit and kind of make it play second fiddle. But I love the way this thing sounds. It's really something else. If you don't have this LP on a big-ass stereo, you're really only hearing half the story, because some of the drums, some of the low end, some of the kicks on this are really, really nice. Not a lot of release on the drums. They're very lean. They're very kind of sharp juts, but very hard. Clicky, clacky. The low end rumbles shake the ground. The highs are nice and crisp and atmospheric. The samples are cut really well. The effects are executed with finesse. And this thing is mixed like a monster. Unless a track is going for a very cacophonous wall of sound, it's very clear. It's very well balanced. Some of the beats here are just a really nice, straightforward, enjoyable no-brainer. Like, were you, can you, are you, felt. Are you, can you, were you, felt. Just a really nice droning string sample, stuttering jazz piano chords, a boom click beat, a very chill, laid-back flow. The whole package of it all kind of puts me in a place that maybe listening to Quasimodo or some other Madlib-related album would. But straight and narrow is not the game this LP plays most of the time. A lot of these beats are out there. You've gotta trust me on this one. Each track has like a plethora of different sounds that I could go into very great detail with, like the opener Free Press and Curl. Very eerie bass hums on that track, just sputtering cymbal hits flying all over both mix channels. There are a lot of effects being used on Palacier's voice as the song evolves, and there are these vocal samples that are literally manipulated, mauled, I would say, to the point where they kind of sound like a steam train whistle blowing. It's weird. Another one of my favorite beats is the second track, and it does this trick. It does this little turn of the hand that I hear on a lot of these tracks that I haven't heard done quite like this before. There's a female vocal sample on there, and it is stretched out just aggressively. Because it's stretched and it's not pitch shifted, there's all these like digital stretch marks on it. It's a noisy sound that maybe another producer would do his or her best to try to eliminate or cover up, but this LP just puts it out in the open, and it's got a pretty surreal quality. There are tracks on here loaded with various synthesizers, bleeps and bloops, like A Treaty Dedicated To, and Eulogy, which that song's first half is basically a cacophonous wall of various sounds and noises. But there are tracks here I like a lot that come off very sparse, very empty. Luckily, Palacier has enough charisma to me to fill an entire stadium, which is really what locks me in with a lot of these tracks. I love the rhymes, I love his flow, I just love the personality, I love the delivery, but I know it's not gonna be for everybody. If you're a boom-bap traditionalist who enjoys a lot of fiery flows, a lot of technical ability, then this is definitely not going to be for you. Though there are some very strong statements made in the lyrics on this LP, it doesn't really go hard. While many rappers are kind of in this bragging competition, this LP is more content kind of sitting in the stands and meditating and making fun of albums that fall prey to cliches like materialism and violence and swag. That Death Grips album I loved earlier this year made that stuff look stupid and ugly by taking it to such an extreme that it couldn't be rationalized by anybody to be good. This album does the same thing, but it does it in a way that's toned down, kind of in a studious way, like it would say these rhymes after closing a book and looking over from its tipped glasses. This thing is just kind of like a socially conscious full-course meal about freedom and racism, society at large, the internet age, hip-hop, making music, attracting girls. And of course there's a bunch of abstract stuff on the menu too, like actually one of my favorite verses. The nights are getting stronger and the days are getting longer. The building's getting bigger, outside is getting smaller. The lies are getting truer and the truth is getting brighter. Things are looking blacker, but black is looking whiter. What? Weird, but I love it. The only thing I'm really kind of mixed on the fence with, is how these songs are put together. We have 10 tracks here, but there are some songs that could easily be 2, because they hit a transitional moment where the track become something completely different. It's not really an evolution as much as it is like an immediate shapeshift of mood. And that's fine, it actually makes this LP kind of a thrill to listen to because it unfolds, it surprises. But there are some songs here that don't have enough track length to fully develop the shifts that they make. The track Endeavors, to me, comes off a little aimless. Its various parts don't connect as much as they kind of clash. And The King's New Clothes just kind of ends and fizzles out for no reason, just as the song sort of seems to be gaining momentum, emotion, and a message. But outside of that, I'm loving this thing. It's a great reminder of how mind-altering and f-up hip-hop music can be, but still sound great while being those things. So I'm kind of feeling a decent 8. On this. A decent 8. But let me know what you're thinking of this. Are you loving it? Are you hating it? Why? And what should I review next? Anthony Fantano, Shabazz Palaces, Black Up, Forever.